soul feels very disquieted, very dispirited, because I haven't gotten to that place of acceptance about whether it's my time or not. I can't get there yet, and I keep praying for acceptance.
Well, maybe you feel so strongly, Gwen, maybe that it's not your time. That's why you feel this way. And maybe that means that it is not your time.
Maybe, but I just want to get into a place of acceptance so right now I could just have some peace of mind. I mean, I'd like to go into that surgery experience in some peace of mind of acceptance, whether if it is my time that I can accept that, and if it's not, then what you said is true, that it wasn't my time and I'm going to get to go home and have a little more time.
Right.
But I'm not there yet.
Well, does going home and having more time sound like an appealing idea to you?
Yeah,
something
does.
You're looking forward to?
Well, if the pain's under control, you know, going home's okay. Because I agree with what Pat said, that I'm learning, I'm still in a learning phase. I mean, there isn't a day that goes by, or there's not a few hours that don't go by where I don't learn something, where something doesn't occur to me and I go, oh yeah, right, this is the way things really are, this is what's real. I mean, I'm still learning. So as long as I'm still learning and my mind is still computing what's real and what isn't, and I'm still getting a sense of what I want and what I don't want, more of what I don't want, and I'm able to make those differentiations, then I think it's worth being here. Don't you?
Of course.
And if the pain's controllable, but then, you know, sometimes when the pain hits, I say, I just want the fuck out of here. I don't care about learning or not learning. Screw all this. I just want the fuck out. And then, like, right now I'm sitting here talking to you and I'm not in pain, and I go, yeah, I mean, it's a drag and I'm hooked up and everything, but, you know, I'm having a great time here with you right this second. And just talking to you, you know, I get to experience you and you know, and everything, and so I... and all the love and everything that I feel for you, Donna, and stuff, and so then I don't want to leave. I mean, if I was sitting here right now and I was in really hurting, that would be different, but I'm not hurting right this second. So as long as I'm not hurting, I want to stay here. Or as long as I'm hurting and it can be controlled, I want to stay.
I totally understand that, Gwen. So maybe you want to rethink your decision. Because something else is on your mind, right?
Yeah.
And what is that other thing?
Well, just that I'm tired too. Well, no, what I'm saying is if I don't throw a clot and I don't die, staying would be okay.
Right.
Because I'm still okay about being alive. But on the other hand, I'm tired. You know, it's been a year. It's coming up on a year and a half, and I'm tired. And if it's my time to go, I don't want to fight to stay here. I mean, I'm tired of fighting. I don't want to fight anymore to stay here. I think I've got it clear about that. But if I do stay, if it's not my time to go, I'm also all right about staying if the pain is controllable.
Yeah.
But I don't want to fight anymore to stay here.
Well, Gwen, I am hearing a lot of acceptance.
You are.
As you explain it. I know you are in turmoil in your mind and in your heart, you know, but as you talk about it, as you articulate your feelings, there seems to be a lot of clarity and acceptance, just as you've told it now.
I look sweet when I cry, don't I?
Yeah.
Everybody says that I break their hearts when I cry. And my face doesn't get ugly when I cry.
Remember what I told you yesterday, Gwen?
What?
What did I say?
You said that I was your best friend.
I've ever had.
Huh?
That I've ever had.
That you've ever had.